Hey everyone, this is Scott from CertMedia.com, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to set up variable products in WooCommerce. This can get a little bit complicated, and I'll be the first to admit that the WooCommerce documentation, it's a little hard to understand how this feature works. This is an example one. I'm going to show you how to create a new product with new variations. I'm going to be using random data that I just come up with on the spot, but you're going to want to go ahead and follow along with the data that you need. So the first place that you want to go to actually isn't your individual product. You're going to want to go to, you're going to hover over products and click attributes. Attributes is where you can actually specify the type of terms that can be associated. So as you could see, I have color set up, and in color, I have blue, gray, green, red, yellow. And then in size, I have large, medium, and small. These are what are used to create variations. Think of these as the different types of products you have. So let's say I'm trying to come up with a cup. So it's gonna be a cup. Well, let's just do a cup for now. So we're gonna do fluid. We're just gonna call it size in ounces. This is a terrible name, but it's just an example. And I'm gonna leave it as the default. This will go ahead and just generate it from this name, and it's going to not really matter so much for the default sort ordering. We're gonna click add attribute. Now that we have the attribute created, this is where we can now associate terms with that attribute. So you click configure items. When you click configure items, this is where you can now specify in the general attribute type the different sizes. So if I have a cup, I may have an 8-ounce cup. And 8-ounce cup is my description. And then I may have a 12-ounce cup. For those of you who don't use ounces, I apologize. But that's what we're doing with. As you can see, I accidentally put cup in the name here, but we're just gonna forget about that. And you're gonna wanna set up each of the different sizes, colors, whatever it is you have a variation of in here. If you're selling a pack of something, you could also specify packs in here. But for now, we're just gonna do my cup sizes. Okay. There we go. So now I'm selling my 16-ounce, 8-ounce, and 12-ounce cups. I don't have a cup as a photo, so we're just gonna skim right past that because it doesn't matter. You could create, in theory, as many attributes as you want. In fact, when I create this product, I'm gonna be borrowing from my color attribute that's already here. I'm gonna have cups that are different colors, I guess. It's just to illustrate the flexibility of attributes, but you're gonna wanna set up all of your product attributes here. It's important that you plan all of them out. You don't want to double up on an attribute that may already exist, and you just don't want to be confusing to your users who are trying to navigate different products. If you're trying to set up an attribute that's product specific, so let's try to say you're selling a pack of something, and one product like a cup, you sell a 2-pack of cups, but on something else, you set up a pack of like 14. You can do all of that within attributes and to specify an individual term for the cup. You can use a term to specify the number in that pack, but don't go creating more attributes than you need, because you're going to get into a little bit of a hassle of trying to micromanage all of them, and it makes it harder to set up variations. So now that we've gone ahead and we set up our size and ounces, we're going to go ahead and create a new product. We're going to call this the Cert Media coffee cup. If you drink tea, that's okay. I also love a nice warm cup of tea. Now, we're just gonna call it, it's a cup. No big deal. Doesn't really matter. I'm just getting in some filler data, and to really throw my audience through a loop, I'm gonna put this nice little picture here because it doesn't matter for the demonstration. And we're gonna put it under the music category. Pay no attention to all of this. What really matters here is the product data. You need to specify it as a variable product. If you have a SKU, you can put your SKU here. That doesn't really matter. We're gonna call it Q. We're gonna call it cup. Now you would want to go ahead and click variations, but variations are actually generated from your attributes that you set up. So under attributes, you're gonna want to go ahead and click the attribute that you want to add. So in this case, I want to add that size in ounces so that way people can pick the size of their mug. And what you can do is select each of the values that are used for this product. And you could go ahead here and set up 12 and 16. I got all my cups right here. You're gonna wanna go ahead and make this used for variations, but then we're also gonna add the color. So what color cups am I going to sell? Let's see, gray, red for the speed demons out there, and the green. All right, so I probably chose the ugliest colors for cups, but it doesn't really matter. And then you're also gonna click used for variations. And now we're going to head and click save. Now what's cool about WooCommerce is because we've selected both of them to be used in variations, you can order in theory an 8-ounce green cup or a 16-ounce red cup. So we come over to variations and now we can go ahead and click create variations from all attributes. So we've gone ahead and we combined it, and it warns you, hey, if you do this, it will generate a variation for each run and every possible combination. So I should be able to order a 8, 12, or 16-ounce green, gray, red cup. So we're gonna go ahead and click OK. It's gonna go ahead and run, and you're just gonna let it do it, and it says it added 9 variations. That's in line where it should be because I have 3 cup sizes and 3 colors. So there's gonna be 3 options per color. And we're gonna click OK. And 9 variations do not have prices. So this is where you have to get into the actual product modification. I'm not going to bore you with all of this too much, but let's just say this variation price is going to be $6 since it's the 12-ounce version. All of our 6 ounces are gonna be $6. I probably would go bankrupt in about a month trying to sell cups, but that's okay. But the 16-ounce ones are going to be $10, and we're going to go ahead and sell them. And our 8-ounce cups, we're going to make them $4. We're pretty cheap here. Our cups are not the best quality, but they can hold a cup of coffee, and that's all we really care for. Now, we set the variation price, which is required. If you don't have a variation price, it will not show. But now you can modify other details. For instance, you can modify the image by clicking this image, and which one is this that I'm selecting? The 8-ounce red cup. So if I select the 8-ounce red cup, if I select that, I expect on the WooCommerce front end that when I click that as my variation type, it should change my image from that weird WooCommerce photo to a beanie. Make sure you're using products that are actually using images for products that you have, because you wanna make sure your users are communicating to what the product that they're gonna get is. So look at this. I went ahead and I added the variation image, but as you can see in WooCommerce, it's only showing that one image. There is no product gallery. But if I choose my 8-ounce red cup, I should see it turn to the beanie. It handles all of that for you in the background, which is honestly one of the great things about using WooCommerce for more in-depth product navigation. So as you can see, we went ahead and did that. And we could set up a product gallery and do all that biz, but this is really all you have to do to get variations set up. I'm gonna give another tip that I oftentimes see people do incorrectly when they're working with variations. As it mentions here, you can set a length, width, and height for the variation itself. Under shipping, you can do that as well. If all of your variations of the product have the exact same weight and dimensions, just set it under the shipping category. It will save you a lot of headache down the line. However, let's say you're selling something like a table, and you have a table that can seat 4 people, or you have a table that can seat 6 people. So you got your small and your large. In that case, you do need to, in the variations, specify the length, width, and height attribute. And then you can worry about shipping classes later, but in a future video, I will definitely cover how to do shipping because, oh, I run, sometimes it's shipping, you just see a lot of people use shipping classes incorrectly to try and solve problems. And then you get into the weeds and the spaghetti of it, and it honestly will drive you crazy. Having proper shipping classes set up from the get-go will just save you so much headache. But that was really all you needed to know about setting up variations. Now you can go ahead and set your SKUs, your images. You can create any variations you need. And I just thought that you would all appreciate that. If you get stuck anywhere or you're just confused about what you should do for your variations, please feel free to ask in the comments below. I will try to help you out the best that I can. Otherwise, please make sure you like the video, you subscribe, and Maybe share it with your friends. This can be quite useful. Thank you so much for watching, and goodbye.